Future-proofing your career means to prepare your career in such a way that you can minimize any shock or stress as a result from future events, developments in the job market or the economy. In simple words, it means to prepare your career in such a way that you are never stuck and never without a choice. In case you're new to this channel, I make videos on multiple careers, career change, and career development, and I believe that you should never feel like you're stuck in a career that you don't want, but that you need to take the ownership and intentionally shape the career that is best for your life. If this is something that you're interested in, then go ahead and subscribe, and also don't forget to hit the little alarm bell. When I first started my career in banking, I was so focused on getting the next promotion, getting the next salary raise, gaining more experience, and that was all good. But I only realized a bit later on that I was focusing on the wrong thing. After a few years in banking, I completely forgot about what I actually wanted to do. What I should have done instead, had I known better back then, is to try and better future-proof my career. And today in this video, I want to talk about why that is so important. The first reason why you need to future-proof your career is because nowadays, no jobs are secure. So gone are the days, perhaps during the time of our parents or grandparents, where someone could reasonably expect to be working in the same job for the same company for his entire life, for 20, 30, or even 40 years. But most of us in our generation have been primed to think of that way. Most parents, and perhaps yours too, have told their children to go and get a good education and find a stable job. But the problem is that nowadays, there is no such thing as a truly stable, secure, or safe job. Nowadays, the job market is very volatile, and that is a result of many different things. Jobs can easily come and go as a result of economic development, changes in the industry, also developments in AI and automation. So going forward in the next 10, 20 years, there will be a lot of jobs that disappear. But at the same time, there will also be a lot of new jobs that will be created. But those jobs in the future will likely demand a new kind of skill set. And also the recent pandemic that has hit a lot of people really hard shows that you cannot rely on your one job. You can never rely on one company to secure your whole career and future. But in some instances, you might say there are secure jobs. There are companies who are willing to keep their employees for 20 or even 30 years. But the question is, still, do you want to be at the mercy of that one company? Because you might still be hired for a long time, but things can change. Things in the company can change. The structure, the way things are done can change. The management and the industry. If you don't future-proof your career, which among others can include diversifying your career, you will forever be at the mercy of this one company. And if things develop in a way that you don't really like, then you can easily become stuck without any other choice. By the way, this is a question for you. Have you thought about your career path, and how well do you think that you are prepared for it? Please let me know in the comments below. The second reason why you need to future-proof your career is because you never want to be stuck with just that one career path that is offered by your company. So each company has a set of different career paths within their company that they offer to their employees. So if the employees do a good job and they perform well, then it is likely that within a certain number of years after a certain performance has been achieved, they can move up the ladder. But the thing is that this career path is shaped in a way that serves the company's needs, meaning that companies set up their career paths for their employees to move on in such a way that will enable the company to meet their goals, their income goals, their profit goals, maximize shareholder value, and so on. And that is all fine because that is ultimately the company's job. And it makes sense that it is their goal to maximize their profit. But the thing is that while this might serve the company's goals, it might not serve your individual goals. Let's take, for example, a typical career path in marketing. Someone could start off as an assistant manager in marketing, work their way up to marketing manager, VP of marketing, and eventually head of marketing. And that makes complete sense for the company, but it might not necessarily be what you want. Perhaps the reason why you started to do marketing is because you wanted to do something creative. But then when you reached a certain level in the company, you realize that in my position as a VP of marketing here in this particular company, I don't really feel that I can exercise my creativity in the way that I imagined. And perhaps you imagine your career to be really different than this. The thing is that most people are so focused on a promotion because they think that the only way to go is further up. But that is fortunately not the case. Moving up in a company is not the only way to progress in your career. There is also such a thing as moving sideways or horizontal career mobility. Another case in which it's really important that you go ahead and future-proof your career is if you want to have the kind of customized career that really suits you and your life. There are many people for whom traditional career paths are suitable. And actually, I'm really glad that those kind of people exist because some people have to fill those positions, right? But then there are people for whom the traditional career path might not be the best one. And the reason could be because they have multiple interests, because there are many things in their lives that they want to do in a professional setting and not just as a hobby. So if you are the kind of person who wants to build a career that is intentional, that is aligned with your vision, with your purpose for life, and that is also suited to the kind of lifestyle that you want to have, then you have to future-proof your career. Then you definitely cannot leave your career development to the HR department of your company. You cannot let that very crucial part of your career and life be solved during a 1 or 2 hour session when you have your biannual or quarterly discussion with your manager or with the HR department. Because while your manager and your HR manager might be glad to help you out with your career goals, they might not really know what those career goals are. And perhaps you might even ask yourself right now, do you yourself know what your career goals are? I believe that the company you work for does have a genuine interest in your career development, but only as long as that also serves their needs. And that makes totally sense. It's not their responsibility to ensure that you will have the kind of career in the long term that you really want. That is not their job. It is your job. So you are the one who needs to take ownership of your career path and your career development. So if you in the long term want to have the kind of career that is purposeful and fulfilling and that you really feel happy about, you need to start future-proofing it yourself, which means that you need to invest in yourself. You need to have a strategy for yourself where you develop your skill, develop your brand. You need to know for the long term what kind of career you truly want to have. And then you also need a strategy. How are you going to achieve that? And how are you going to future-proof your career, invest in yourself so that in the long term you can pursue a career that you want and you never feel stuck and without a choice? I hope this video was useful to you. One of my next videos will talk about what you can concretely do to future-proof your career. So if you don't want to miss that video, then don't forget to subscribe and hit the alarm bell in case you haven't. As always, I thank you so much for watching. I wish you an awesome day, all the best with your career development, and I hope to see you again soon.